Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Custom GPTs are one of the most useful things you can do with ChatGPT. You can create your own GPT that to do a specific task. It's dead easy to do. I'm going to show you how to do it. Let's get into it. Okay, here we are in ChatGPT. So you go over to your picture at the top and you say, my GPTs. And then it brings you into this area where you can see the GPTs that you might have created. These are a whole load that I've done. I use them a lot. And you press at the top and say create GPT. This brings you into this screen and you've got create and configure over here on the left hand side. And then on the right hand side, you get a preview of what you want to do. Okay, so my son, Alex, is applying for jobs. So I thought I would create a custom GPT to help him with interview preparation. So I've said in the prompt here down on the left, create a GPT designed to help you prepare effectively for job interviews, offering tailored questions, feedback, and tips. So the first thing it does is say, great, now let's pick a name for your GPT. How about Interview Prep Coach? Let me know if you like it, want a different name. That's fine. It then says, now let's create a profile picture for the interview prep coach, generate an initial design, and it has. Is that okay? Yes, that's fine. Jump over to the other side. So I've done that, said, awesome, interview prep coach is all set. You can start using it to prepare for interviews now. Let me know if you want me to tweak anything. And on the right-hand side, you have the interview prep coach. Now we can do better than that. Let's go in and configure it. You click at the top with configure. And you get a whole series of things that the GPT has pre-populated for you. So name, interview prep coach, helps users prepare for job interviews with tailored questions, feedback, and tips. GPT is designed to help users prepare effectively for job interviews. It provides tailored questions based on the user's target role, industry, and experience level. It offers constructive feedback on answers, suggests improvements, and provides expert tips on interview techniques. Additionally, it can help with behavioral questions, technical assessment, and salary negotiation strategies. This GPT adapts its responses based on the user input, ensuring relevant and practical guidance. It maintains a professional yet supportive tone, encouraging users to refine their responses to boost confidence for their interviews. I'll go in the middle this time. So it also gives you the conversation starters here on the left-hand side, and over on the right-hand side, you can see the conversation starters that are already in the interview prep coach GPT. Now, what we want to do is to improve this, to give it some knowledge so that it knows how to answer. So you'll see below you have knowledge and you can upload files. So I'm going to upload some files. Here are four documents that I've prepared, 100 common interview questions, some interview techniques, tips for confidence in interviews, and trick questions that you might face. I'm just going to copy all of these. They all get uploaded to the GPT, and then you can ask it what capabilities you want to use. So web search, we'll leave that on. Canvas, we'll leave that on. I don't think we're going to need to be doing image generation, and we don't need code interpreter or data analysis. So if you want to link your GPT to a database or another piece of software, you can create a new action and putting your API key or your URL, etc. here, and it will be able to draw in on that information. We're not going to do that. We don't need it for this. Basically, put all our information in. We've created our GPT and you just press create. And at the moment, we're going to say it is anyone with a link. We will save that. And there we go. It's as simple as that. You go back into ChatGPT and you have Interview Prep Coach, and you can always find it from My GPTs. There it is. Takes you in. And what I would suggest that you do now is that you test it. You see how it works. If it's right, if it's giving you good answers or not, you use it, test it, and it will get better. And if you're using it specifically, it will get better for you. Let's try it out. And you give me some common question interview questions for software engineers. It gives you general questions, technical questions, coding and algorithm questions, systems design questions, behavioral questions. Would you like a sample answer to any of these or help in structuring the response? So I will say this one, copy, paste. So I've copied that particular question out and said, give me a sample response. Here's a strong sample response using the STAR method, situation, task, action, result. In my previous role as software engineer at XYZ Corp, we were in the middle of a product release when we discovered a critical performance issue in our application. The system slowed down drastically under high user loads, causing significant delays and affecting the user experience. That's the situation. The task: as one of the lead engineers on the team, I was responsible for identifying the root cause and implementing a fix before the scheduled release without compromising other features. 5, I immediately collaborated with DevOps and QA teams to replicate the issue in the staging environment, resolved it, and the result, after implementing these changes, the application response time improved by 60%. There you go. It can give you a helpful way of structuring an answer. It's not your specific answer, because if you go back into the knowledge area and put your own CV in, then it will draw from that CV around your knowledge. Let's try something else. So I've said, I'm feeling nervous, can't spell, about an upcoming interview. Please give me some tips. Feeling nervous before an interview is completely normal. Here's some practical tips to help you stay calm and confident. Prepare thoroughly. Search the company, review the job description, practice common questions, do some mock interviews. I wonder if we could do a mock interview with this GPT. Manage pre-interview anxiety. Reframe your nerves as excitement. Power poses. Stand tall, shoulders back. Take a deep breath before entering the interview. Visualization. Picture yourself confidently answering questions. Positive self-talk. Control your body language. Walk in with confidence. Maintain good posture. Use natural hand gestures, make eye contact, pace your speaking and breathing, prepare for the unexpected. If you get a tricky question, stay calm. Have some questions ready. What do you enjoy most about working here? What challenges is your team currently facing? How does success look in this role after 6 months? Take care of yourself before the interview. Good night's sleep. Remember, the interview is a two-way street. You're evaluating them as well as them evaluating you. Cool. We've created this. You saw in a matter of seconds. Okay, so it suggested we do some interview preparation and practice. So I said, could you interview me for an analyst role, please, as practice for an upcoming interview? See what it does. See if it will start asking me questions. Of course, conduct a mock interview for you for an analyst role. Tell me about yourself. Aim for a concise summary, background skills. Wouldn't it be great if you could actually speak to it? Yeah. Could you undertake a mock interview for an analyst role, please?
Absolutely. Let's start a mock interview for an analyst role. I'll ask you a series of behavioral, technical, and situational questions. You can answer them one by one, and I'll provide feedback after each response. Mock analyst interview. Tell me about yourself. Aim for a concise summary of your background, relevant skills, and why you're interested in this role. Go ahead and answer, and I'll provide feedback.
Hi, I've been an analyst for quite a few years now. I really enjoy the work. And I think that this opportunity in your company will be really interesting for me. It will help me expand what I'm doing and help me to grow as an analyst.
Great start. Your answer is concise and positive, but it could be stronger by including specific details about your experience, skills, and what makes you a good fit for this role. Here's a refined version. I have been an analyst for several years, specializing in mentioned area, e.g. financial, business, or data analysis. I enjoy transforming complex data into meaningful insights that drive business decisions. In my current role at company name, I have worked on mention a key project or achievement where I describe impact, e.g. improved efficiency, reduced costs, increased revenue. I'm excited about this opportunity because your company's focus on mention company initiative or industry aligns with my experience and passion. I'm eager to bring my analytical skills to your team and continue growing as an analyst in a dynamic environment. Would you like to try again with more specifics?
So I'd love to, but I think what we're going to do is move on. Otherwise, you're going to sit there and decide whether I should become an analyst or not. How cool is that? There you go. It gives you what I said, and then it gives you the answer. So you can just speak to it. Very, very helpful. So now let's push it a bit further. I've asked it to give me a set of trick questions I might be asked for a job as a civil servant and some suggested answers. And here it goes. How would you handle a situation where a senior official asks you to do something unethical? Why is this tricky? They want to assess your integrity, professionalism, and ability to handle sensitive situations. Integrity is a key value in the public service, and I take ethical standards very seriously. If a senior official asked me to do something that seemed unethical, I would first seek clarification to ensure I fully understand the request. If it remained unethical, I would politely but firmly explain my concerns, referencing the Civil Service Code of Conduct and relevant policies. If necessary, I would escalate the issue to an appropriate compliance or ethic department to ensure transparency and accountability. If there's some more, what would you do if you strongly disagreed with the government policy but had to implement it? That happens. Could you give an example of time when you had to deal with a difficult stakeholder or member of the public? Have you had multiple urgent tasks with conflicting deadlines? How would you prioritize your work? I think that always gets asked, doesn't it? Assess each task based on its deadline, impact, and urgency. If necessary, I would seek clarification from my manager to ensure alignment with organizational priorities. I also use structured time management techniques like the Eisenhower matrix, urgent versus important, to project management tools to track tasks effectively. If I needed, I would communicate proactively with stakeholders to manage expectations and ensure the most critical work was completed on time. I think we always get asked that question, don't we? Why do you want to work in the civil service? Loads there. You can see how useful. Okay, so if you want to share your GPT, you can go into My GPTs, go into Edit GPT, and then you can share it, or you can publish it on the GPT store, which I have done. So this GPT is available to you now. You can go into the GPT store. It's free. You can save it. And go in and you can use it, use all the information that I've put in there. So if you're on ChatGPT and you want to go to explore GPTs and you put in interview prep coach in the search bar, if you go down, you should find interview prep coach. There we go. Help users prepare for job interviews. So you can use it, have a play, see if it helps you. Okay, how easy was that? Now you think about what you could use a customized GPT for. You could use it for all sorts of things in getting a new job, creating cover letters for interview preparation. You could use it for creating blogs or a health plan. I've done that before. All sorts of things that you could use ChatGPT for to support you in your individual life. Custom GPTs are really useful. Go and have a go. Think about a task where a customized GPT that has your information, your data, draws on your knowledge, how you could use that effectively, and go and have a go at building one. I've shown you how to do it. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, don't forget to smash me a like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.